Welcome to the show, Elizabeth, and thanks so much for coming on the program.
Thank you for having me.
So first, I'm curious, how did you decide to audition for a show like MasterChef?
I am a huge fan of the show. I was addicted to season 4, and I was just sitting at home watching the show and thinking, you know, I think I could actually maybe cut it on a show like this. I love to cook. I think I could handle it. And I just went to an open call audition, and the rest is history.
Were there any dishes that you really wanted to show off that you're known for at home that you had hoped to bring into the competition?
I was really excited to make lasagna. That's actually what I made for my open call. I, you know, stood out in the cold with my giant lasagna for a few hours. And I was really excited to make at least a riff on lasagna during the competition.
So when it came to the lasagna you made in the competition, what made yours stand out from everyone else?
I think that it was just kind of on the fly, and it seems like something that's, you know, really complicated, but I actually ended up, you know, churning it out in basically an hour.
That's amazing, especially the fact that lasagna, it almost seems like it's such a delicate Italian dish. It has a lot of cook time, so to be able to turn it out in an hour must have been a very impressive accomplishment for yourself.
Yeah, it was super stressful, but I found during the competition, really all the challenges that I was kind of running on adrenaline, and I was working at, you know, 10 times my normal speed, so I went into, like, superhuman mode.
So for you, you found that pressure, that added pressure, and that time really helped you to stay focused, to get in gear, and not necessarily feel the pressure in a negative way.
Yeah, I definitely felt like, I mean, the clock is scary. Watching the time tick away is incredibly stressful, but ultimately, you know, you just keep the win in your mind. And I mean, I definitely felt like it was an advantage for me because I do work best under pressure. I always have. So for me, it worked out.
Now, what were maybe some of the top things that you learned on a show like MasterChef that can help you to grow, whether it's cooking at home for your family and friends, or maybe it's looking to go into the food business?
I feel like my biggest takeaway as far as cooking goes is just to not overcomplicate things. I mean, we all kind of realized throughout the course of the competition that what the judges were really looking for almost always was just something executed really well. They weren't looking for the craziest idea always. They were just looking for something that was simple and well thought out and well executed. And I think that it's, you know, it's always tempting to overcomplicate things, especially when you're trying to impress someone. But with food, you know, when you're using really great ingredients, if you keep the techniques on point, then you're always going to come out with something delicious.
So what would you say is something to help encourage those people who don't necessarily consider themselves the best cook? Maybe their specialty is a bowl of cereal and milk.
I would just say, you know, don't be afraid to try things because, you know, I think everybody's really afraid of failure. But, I mean, I've cooked thousands and thousands of dishes in my life, and not all of them have been great, but very few of them have been inedible. So I think, you know, just try things and you're going to learn really, really quickly. So it's just trial and error, just like everything else.
So it really is about experimenting. It's almost as if you're taking the science classes and doing those experiments into the kitchen.
Absolutely. I think you just got to say, hey, is this going to work? Like, how's this going to taste if I boil it? How's this going to taste if I fry it? And you kind of just got to take chances and find out what works for you and what appeals to your taste.
So since your time on the show, what has this really been an opportunity to open doors for you?
Yeah, the show has been really great. I've hosted a couple of dinners, and I actually got an offer the other day to cook for someone's rehearsal dinner for their wedding, which is a big honor. So it's really just taken, you know, I've always cooked for my friends and family and stuff, but it's really taken it to the next level of me kind of putting myself on a bigger stage as far as food goes.
So since you've gotten all of these offers to cook some of these specialty dinners, including the rehearsal dinner, can we see you maybe doing a catering kind of business, or will it maybe stay something on the side so that the fun in it remains?
Yeah, you know, I'm really still trying to decide. I have my whole advertising career that is still, it's still going strong and it's still meaningful to me. It's something that I care about as well. But I think that I'm just going to take my time and, you know, just keep writing. I have a blog that I'm pretty committed to and keep taking pictures. And just, I'm just going to sort of roll with the opportunities as they come. And I think that, that things are just going to continue to come out of the woodworks for me.
Well, if that opportunity does go to having your own food business, I think with the advertising career, you're pretty set with the business side, too.
I hope, I would like to think so. I definitely feel like I understand, like, marketing and promoting myself, and, of course, I understand cooking. I think the big question mark for me is always the sort of, like, financial side. I'm not this world's biggest math whiz, so that kind of scares me. But I think that if you're cooking good food, you can find somebody to run the numbers for you.
Oh, definitely. Now, I do want to ask about anyone else from the show that maybe you've remained close with, because even though it is a competition, what I feel like we've all learned is that it becomes a family.
Absolutely. I would say, for some reason, the New York crew kind of ran together, you know, off camera. Christine, who's the investment director from Yonkers, she and I stay in close contact. Jamie from Queens, the girl with all the tattoos, she and I were, everyone was kind of surprised that we were such good friends. I guess, sort of, just to look at us, we seem like we'd be really different, but she's like one of my closest friends from the show. And Victoria, who's from Texas. She actually lives in Brooklyn as well, so I see her quite a bit.
So it definitely sounds like you guys are very close location-wise, and also that friendship's going to remain throughout watching the show and also just outside of the show completely.
Yeah, that was one of sort of the most wonderful and unexpected things I gained from the show was I really do, I mean, you said it. You said it's like a family. I feel like I have this food family of people that that I'm very lucky to live close to and get to see frequently. And it's just such a gift to really have people that I can say is kind of a new food family for me.
Oh, well, that's exciting. Now, I'm curious to know, if MasterChef decides maybe to do an all-star season, they approach you, would you sign up to compete again?
Oh, absolutely. I hope they do it. they definitely should. It was a crazy experience, and there were a lot of things that were hard about it, but it's the coolest thing I've ever done. It's the most fun I've ever had, and I would relish an opportunity to do anything with MasterChef in the future.
And that's awesome to hear so much passion for something, when like a possible food career, or even just something that maybe you want to keep as a hobby that you just love doing that much.
Yeah, I mean, nothing makes me happier than being in the kitchen cooking. Every free minute is spent doing that and cooking for other people. So whether I do turn it into, you know, my next full-time career or just keep it as a hobby, I know that it's the thing that fulfills my life. It fills my heart to just be in the kitchen cooking for people.
Well, I'm glad, and hopefully they will have an all-star season and you'll get the chance to compete and maybe become the master all-star.
Absolutely. I hope so, too.
Now, you did mention that you have a blog, so where can people go to read more posts and stay updated with you?
My personal website is elizabethcauvelcooks.com and just /blog if you want to go straight to the blog.
Awesome. Thanks so much for coming on the program, Elizabeth.
Thanks for having me. Have a great day.
You too.